So before you start using Git, I want to tell you about the gitignore file. Let's say Anne has some repository with private notes and a video reference file that both don't need to go into the repository. Anne creates a temp folder where she wants to put things that shouldn't be included in the repository. As Git is not really meant for large binary files like videos, it is a good practice to keep these out of version control. Git has no way of storing the changes between these files, which means that it will store every full version of these large files in everyone's .git folder and on the server, if you choose to put them in anyway. This can easily get out of hand, leading to immensely large repository folders and possibly slowing pull and push operations. If this file is still needed in the project, you can't put it into the temp folder, but you can simply choose to ignore all MP4 video files. Let's first see how to ignore certain files using SourceTree. In SourceTree, both the video file and the Word file in the temp folder are showing. To ignore them, you can simply right-click them and click Ignore. You can then choose what to ignore. In this case, all files beneath the temp folder. You'll see that the Word file disappears and a new file appears named .gitignore. I can stage the file to distribute the ignore rule I just created to all collaborators. But first, I'll also add the rule to ignore all files with the .mp4 extension. The video file now also disappeared. As you can see, the .gitignore file contains one line for each ignore rule. Now Anne commits and pushes this new .gitignore file. And Ben pulls. Ben now has the new gitignore file, and Anne can keep her extra files in the folder without them showing up in Git. Now you have learned everything you need to get started using Git in a real project. After you get comfortable with the remotes, cloning, committing, pulling and pushing, there are a few more videos explaining some more useful ways to work with Git, each one a little more advanced. You could watch the next part quite soon, as it explains stashing, a very useful function.